We have Sri Amit Vyas, Managing Director, Kerala District Cooperative Milk Union. He has first-hand experience with the intricacies involved in managing dairy operations during COVID-19 in the historic Amul Dairy, one of the largest dairies in the country. And we have with us Sri Vinesh Shah, Executive Director, National Dairy Development Board, a dairy technologist with upfront experience in production equipment development for dairy industry, and an in-depth understanding of the dairy sector in the country. He is also a meticulous planner influencing dairy policies in the country. It is an honor to have you all here with us. I now invite Sri Vinesh Shah, Executive Director, NDDB, to initiate the discussion.
Good afternoon and namaste to all. On behalf of NDDB and our chairman, I welcome all the dairy professionals who have joined this webinar from different parts of the country. I hope that you all are safe and taking good care of yourself and your family. You might have come across several articles which our chairman has wrote in last couple of months post-COVID scenario. Yes, and emphatically told in all these articles, congratulating all of you for ensuring not only uninterrupted supply of meat and milk products to our consumers, but also taking all the milk available with the farmers, procuring all the milk from the farmers, and even if the demand is less, processing it, maybe converting into long-life product. And in this challenging time, all the dairies have done a commendable job. I don't think you all are less than the coronavirus warriors which we have been discussing from last 2 months in our country. If I quickly sum up what the dairy sector is currently facing, as I told, the milk procurement has increased. Most of the cooperatives and the organized dairies are procuring much more milk today after the COVID pandemic. Maybe because of the smaller players have stopped procurement, the farmers have no other window to sell, and cooperatives are, cooperatives have a policy to procure all the milk which is available from farmers. Not only they are procuring the milk from their members alone, they have also started procuring milk from even non-members. And at the same time, because of the ongoing lockdown in many parts of our country, the sales of milk and milk products have declined, though in the recent time, in last few days, we have seen the reversal of sales being picked up, but still all dairy processors are facing this challenge. And on top of it, we have a challenge in terms of shortage of labor, shortage of raw materials, inventory, packing materials, because many of these manufacturers are not allowed to work, or they are in the zones where they cannot manufacture these products. We are also facing a situation of working capital, because more and more milk procured which is not sold, so all surplus milk is being converted into long shelf life commodities like skim milk powder and butter, and the cooperatives and the dairy processors are continuing to store these products, and their inventory is getting blocked, and there is a high requirement of the working capital. We hope that our initial response, though, was designed to deal with the situation till the lockdown period. You know, we never thought initially that it will be lockdown 1.0, and we will be today in the lockdown 4.0. Everybody thought that 14 days is the life of virus, so let us break the cycle of this virus, and after 14 days of lockdown or 20 days of lockdown, we will break the cycle, or we will flatten the curve. But all those, you know, our assumptions or what we thought had not come true. Daily the cases are going increasing day by day, and today I think we will cross 1 lakh cases in our country. So now in the lockdown 4.0, we have to realize, it's a harsh realization, that COVID-19 pandemic continues. I think as the government of India is also saying, now we'll have to live with the COVID-19 And whatever challenges we have faced, and we have corrected ourselves, modified ourselves in the entire dairy value chain, maybe starting from the producer level to the consumer level, I think we'll have to continue these modifications or these challenges, you know, how we have treated those challenges in the post-COVID period, maybe for in the near future, and it may become a new normal. Agility on its part, you know, when the challenge came, we started our response. We immediately, I think on the next day, the lockdown was announced. We circulated the do's and don'ts to all the cooperatives. And in the next few days, the retail guidelines with the pictures were issued for the entire value chain at different levels, what care we need to take. For example, we have the dairy farm level. I think we are fortunate that NDDP has been advocating the clean milk production programs from last maybe 15, 20 years. These clean milk production programs and the education which we have provided to farmers, I think it is sufficient even today to deal with the COVID-19 challenges. However, these are the certain guidelines which were issued at, for the dairy farm level. Let me clarify that there are many questions which have come with regard to the transmission of COVID from human to animal. But as of now, whatever evidences we have, it clearly suggests that there is no transmission possible from human to animal. So I think at farm level, with the clean milk production practices which we are already undergoing, like cleaning and sanitization of the hands of the milker, we are also cleaning the animal, and we are taking care of cleaning and sanitizing all the utensils which we are using for sanitization. So with these two things, I think we are safe fairly at the dairy farmer level. However, the biggest challenge is at the DCS level or the milk pooling point. I think this is the most vulnerable area if we see the COVID infection, possibility of taking the COVID infection. And I think the most of the dairy processors cooperatives throughout the country have also realized this aspect, that this is the most vulnerable area. And they have actually realized this very quickly. And we have seen in the next few days how the cooperatives are dealing at the DCS level, like cleaning the hand with the sanitizers. The members are pouring milk only. Those members who have masks, they are allowed to enter into DCS. We have seen lot many photographs, you know, starting from maybe Gujarat to Assam and maybe Uttarakhand to Kerala. Everybody is practicing social distancing at the DCS level. You can see some of the photographs yourself. Every cooperative, every dairy processor is following these practices, which have kept our milk hygiene level under control. A similar maybe situation exists at the DMC level or cleaning center. And we'll have to take care that whatever vehicles are entering these premises, they have to be sanitized in addition to the people who are entering. And I think this is the opportunity which we'll have to use for having the digital mode of milk receipts and payments. Last 3-4 years, Government of India and NDDP, along with the major cooperatives, are focusing on the digital mode of payment. Many of the our milk members have now Jandan accounts open, and we should take this opportunity to see that we stop cash payment to the producers for the milk they are supplying, and let us use the digital mode. And COVID has also raised certain challenges at the management level. So we had advised the different cooperatives in our country to designate a COVID-19 contact person who can take care of coordinating these activities during this pandemic. It is better to have a room isolated in the dairy plant, which we were not having till now. But I think post-COVID, we'll have to realize that an isolation room in the dairy plant is essential. And this will help us to deal with COVID patient or the symptomatic patient whenever we have. We can isolate them in the room and then take the necessary actions thereafter. We'll also have to educate our employees that whenever they have some symptoms, COVID-19 symptoms, they do not report for duty. and they should be immediately advised to seek the medical assistance. I think we have seen all the dairy plants out now regularly using the hand washing, sanitization station, sanitization channel. Other day we visited Amul and we saw there. So most of these things are being taken care at the dairy plant level. Again, we are fortunate that major dairy plants are using either ISO or other quality systems in most of the dairy plants they have, which is helping us in dealing the COVID better, because all these controls we were already having in the dairy processing plants earlier. And the another area which has posed challenges is the reception and the dispatch docks, because not only the vehicles enter in this area, but we have seen many drivers and conductors also enter in these areas of the dairy plant. So because of this COVID situation, now I think we'll have need to take better care for these drivers and cleaners who are entering the premises of dairy plant. Let us sanitize the vehicles which are entering the dairy plant, hand washing and parking arrangement for these drivers and cleaners, if possible. I think Amul has also started providing lunch or dinner. You know, if they are in that time entering the dairy union, then they have their food also in the dairy premises, so that they don't leave out to and fro from the dairy plant, and which can avoid, which can have a better hygiene practices in the plant. The another thing I think which we'll have to now use this opportunity is the movement of papers. I think we still use lot of papers for, you know, quality control reports going from this, maybe dispatch dock to the quality control lab, or quality control lab to the reception dock of the union. Let us see that all these papers move digitally. I think this is a high time that we move toward digitization of these all these records and moving it through the way. And lastly, I think I'll have to conclude by saying that every crisis brings with itself an opportunity. Our Prime Minister in the last address also emphasized that COVID is you know, is a pandemic. It has posed lot of challenges to us, but how can India use this pandemic into having opportunities? I think the dairy cooperatives also have to use these opportunities. And for example, we have now a lot of producers or non-members who are supplying milk to us. So the cooperatives need to think how we can keep them continuously as our members, and how we can help them so that they continuously give milk to us. Similarly, on the demand front, I think with this COVID pandemic, the consumers have realized that only the hygienic products which are packed in the dairy plants, which are quality certified, we can have a better, you know, we can deal with COVID better. So more and more demand is likely to come with these organized players in the dairy sector. And let us try to now convert all these unorganized sector, you know, whatever products they are selling, like loose curd, there are so many examples we have. How can the organized players convert this opportunity by having these consumers coming to the organized sector? And this is also an opportunity for many of our cooperatives and dairy plants, not only to give quality products to the nation, but let us improve the quality in such a way that more and more dairy products we are able to export. Thank you so much. I now request Dr. J.D. Prajapati, Principal and Dean, Dairy Science College, to have his opening remarks.
Namaskar. In this era of COVID-19 pandemic, we are all concerned, and every day, probably from several news channels, we are finding so many things about the hygiene and safety and everything. So probably we do not need much training on that because it is very extensive. But I would like to highlight two points and then we'll see that how we can tackle this problem. So as a professional, as a dairy professional, you have to realize that milk is an essential commodity. This is दूसरे सब वॉरियर्स है ऐसे डेयरी वाले भी वॉरियर्स है तो इट बिकम्स अवर ड्यूटी टू कलेक्ट व्हाट एवर मिल्क इज प्रोड्यूस प्रोसेस इट एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूट ऑल द पर्सन कीपिंग इन माइंड द सेफ्टी ऑफ द कंज्यूमर दैट इज अवर फोकस एंड व्हेन वी वांट टू कीप दिस इन माइंड वी कैन टैकल दिस सिचुएशन इफ वी मैनेज एट थ्री डिफरेंट लेवल I have indicated here first is awareness that you have to understand the situation. You have to diagnose the problem. What is the situation? And then once you are aware, you will educate yourself. You have to get the knowledge, you have to find the situation and get ready. And then third point is very effective execution of the policy. I will start with some basic knowledge about the virus. Let's do it. You might have seen many animated pictures in the television, but this coronavirus, which we call, is not new. It is probably more than 8,000 years old. Look to Wikipedia, you will find it. But this model, which has come in last 4 or 5 months, is different because it is mutated. All viruses are dead. They become live only when they infect the host cell. So if they are outside the host, we should not worry about it. It will slowly decay. अपने आप मर जाएगा उसको मारने की जरूरत नहीं. And they are very small. They are invisible. जो दिखता है ना उसके साथ आपको काम करने का है. Actually in dairy industry we are always worried about coliform failure. जो भी डेयरी वाले मिलता था how we control coliform coliform. तो जैसे coliform के लिए आप एक मेस करके आप उसको फाइट कर रहे थे ऐसा भी वायरस को भी ध्यान में रखने का. आप पिक्चर में देखोगे तो जो ब्लू कलर का अंदर से वही मेन खतरनाक मटेरियल है जिसको हम आरएनए कहते हैं वो सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड एरर में छोटा सा ही निकल कर सकते हैं बट लकीली दिस वायरस इज दैट उसके आउटर कोट पे कुछ लिपिड्स है इसलिए हम एक अवॉइड करते हैं कि आप हाथ धो तो साबुन से धो या जो वॉशिंग मशीन में साबुन यूज करो क्योंकि साबुन से ये लिपिड वॉश आउट हो जाते हैं मतलब उसका कोट टूट जाएगा तो कोट टूट जाएंगे तो अपना वायरस मर जाता है इससे हमारा जो खतरा होता है वायरस को लड़ने का वो कम हो जाता है एनीवे ये वायरस अलग अलग जगह से आते हैं बहुत सारे अपने मीटिंग में देख लिया है कि जो पर्सन टू आर सफरिंग उसमें से स्प्रे होता है उसका कफिंग स्नीजिंग वगैरह से ड्रॉपलेट से और ड्रॉपलेट करीबन 6 फीट तक पहले ही नीचे गिर जाता है एक बार सॉइल पर गिर जाए तो उसका खतरा बहुत कम हो जाता है इसलिए उससे हम ज्यादा चिंता नहीं करते ओनली वी आर वरीड अबाउट द एक्टिव ड्रॉपलेट दैट इज वाई वी आर आस्क टू फॉलो सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग And virus, once it is infected, what it can do, everybody knows that it has common symptoms. And if your immunity is stronger, you do not have any symptom. So, आपको कुछ नहीं हो रहा does not mean that you may not have virus. You may have, but you are not able to. That is why, even if you are healthy, you should practice all those practices which have been advised by the government. Next, please. So, once you are aware about the thing, हाउ टू एजुकेट आवरसेल्फ और जैसे मैनेज जी ने बताया ये सब प्रैक्टिसेस हमारे जो ऑन ग्राउंड ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम होते हैं एनडीटीपी है कोऑपरेटिव यूनियंस और फेडरेशन एनिमल हेल्थ एंड मैनेजमेंट का एनवायरमेंट मैनेजमेंट का पर्सनल हाइजीन मिल्किंग मशीन केयर उसका ट्रांसपोर्टेशन स्टोरेज प्रोसेसिंग कहाँ केयर लेने के लिए वो सब सिस्टमेटिक ट्रेनिंग मिलती रहती है और ऐसे प्रोग्राम अभी बहुत सारे ऑनलाइन के चालू होंगे तो आप उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करके अपने आप को एजुकेट करो So that you know that where is the problem and how it can be tackled. So this is not a big thing. These are very simple and small things, but we have to be sincere, honest to follow it. Next thing. Lastly, जो है हमको control measure execute करना है. Execution is very important. Advice तो बहुत देते हैं. मगर हम फिर उसको let go करते हैं. छोटी-छोटी चीजें ignore नहीं करते. Because we are fighting the enemy which is not visible. अगर दुश्मन सामने दिखता है तो उसको मारने में बहुत आसान है मगर दिखता नहीं उसको मारने के लिए हमको अपनी तरह से इंटरनली प्रिपेयर होना पड़ेगा सो वी नो दैट मिल्क इज नॉट अ कैरियर ऑफ वायरस और एनी फूड प्रोडक्ट ऐसे वायरस का कैरियर नहीं है जो प्रोसेस फूड है उसमें
only milk pasteurization that is enough to kill it. However, we have to handle the packaging material. और बाहर की साइड जब उसका बिल की पाउटी हो और उसका पैकेजिंग में हैंडल होता है और कहीं भी टच करता है जिस सरफेस पे कहीं इफेक्ट हो सकता है एंड वो टू टेक केयरफुल एंड वो टू टेक केयर सच सच थिंग का सैनिटाइज प्रॉपर्ली एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी एडवाइस कंज्यूमर दैट व्हेन यू परचेस अ पाउच ऑफ बिल जस्ट रिंस इट प्रॉपर्ली वॉश इट प्रॉपर्ली सो दैट नथिंग इज सीरियस अबाउट इट ऑल मटेरियल शुड बी क्लीन डेली प्लांट शुड बी टेकन केयर एस्पेशली इन द प्लांट लेवल यू टू टेक केयर ऑफ मिल्किंग मशीन बल्क कूलर टैंकर पाइप लाइन वाल जहाँ जहाँ हिडन पार्ट है जहाँ मिल्क सॉलिड एक्टिवेट हो सकते हैं उसमें बैक्टीरिया भी हो सकते हैं साथ साथ दूसरे चीजें भी हो सकते हैं इसलिए ऐसी चीजों जो ज्यादा दिखती नहीं है उसको बहुत अच्छी तरह से क्लीन एंड सैनिटाइज करें दैट इज अवर मोटो तो विद दिस आई कंट्रोल माई टॉक एंड आई विल हैप्पी टू टेक एनी क्वेश्चन लेटर ऑन थैंक यू
Sir, we'll take the questions at the end. We already received the questions from many participants and we'll be taking them at the end. I now invite Sri Amit Vyas to deliver his enlightening talk.
Good afternoon, everyone. And Vinesh and Dr. Prajapati Sahab and all those people who are along in this webinar. So, well, thank you very much for joining. And from Amul perspective, we would certainly like to share what can be done under these circumstances, what Amul has done over a period of time. To start with, let me tell you, this is my third experience. Maybe why third is the first one I remember was in 2001, when I was in Banasteri, and that time we had earthquake. So we learned a lot about earthquake that time. Second was in 2006 in Seoul, Day, Surat, I remember that was the first incident where we had floods over there. Now, this is the third time which we are now seeing this pandemic COVID-19, which is it's very different, life-threatening, and it's making us learn every now and then. Now, certainly I'm coming to the point that till date we have been fortunate. The first job was to collect the milk at any point of time, and till date all the milk unions have done excellent job in collection of milk and Abu did part of it. At the same time, there was a demand that surplus of milk from the village level cooperative, apart from village level cooperatives, was supposed to be handled. That was also been done and still going on at this point until it totally gets over. So, what are the measures that needs to be to prevent this COVID-19 during the milk handling? I'll put this in three perspective. One is the first one is the village level cooperative, which Meenesh Bhai has shared most of the information. But the most important thing here is what happens if you have a case over there at the village level cooperative. We had a lot of experience on that. And we said the first thing was to improve the moral of the village level cooperative society. And that's where the first thing was to give them the mask. We provided almost 600,000 of masks to the farmers just to make them aware that how important mask is in their life now it is. And though now as we also said that it's now mandatory to have the mask. Coming to the village level cooperative, you can see a lot of photographs over there, and once they reach, you need to have the sanitizer. Once you have the sanitizer, we are now working on getting the good temperature guns at the village level cooperative society, which is working going on. Very soon we will have it at all the village level cooperative societies, where at least farmers' temperature can be monitored, and at least at the before they pour in, we come to know that okay, this farmer is healthy or the member is healthy. So that is where the change has come. People have realized it. Disinfectant is the key, wherein initially how to disinfect was a big challenge, but we said that at farmer level and the farm level, you have the spraying at the field, with the pesticides and all. He said, let us try to use that pump and try to get it and then use it for after cleaning, use it for disinfectant. So all that disinfectant and everything has been done now. Now, what happens in case there's a case of COVID positive case in that particular village? So what needs and what has changed over a period of time is that we have not stopped the milk production. Though we were in touch with the government authorities and they said that okay, once they give the clearance, all our drivers who are moving there with the trucks are with the PPE suit. We have given PPE suit and apart from full protection, we are sending the truck to collect the milk at the village level cooperative society. And at the same time, they are also wearing masks. They are also in their truck. They have the sanitizer in their truck, and the driver takes care of the conductor who gets down. And once it comes back, the truck comes back. So all these things needs to be done, you know, there, because it is going to, it's not ended, it is still going on. So we need to be very particular that once the truck comes in, you need to clean the truck with high pressure hose. We are now cleaning the trucks coming from the COVID areas. So we clean those trucks with high pressure jets, and we ensure that the person who has gone there also been again sanitized before he enters or in the premises. The PPE suit gets destroyed. Now we have SOPs and advisory released on handling of the tanker coming to the from the village level over to the dairy plant, and where the farmers, it's the truck driver and the conductors, you know, when this kind of situation arises, the most important aspect is that we need to isolate the people, so that, you know, in case of any kind of carrier that comes to the dairy plant, that has to be avoided in any case. But we have to be very careful. So what we did was, we started having all these conductors and driver being handled separately for their food, because food was a big challenge, or tea was a big challenge. So we have now put up a shed, a separate area where all drivers, conductors come and they sanitize themselves. They have to pass, you know, when the truck comes inside the premises, they have to, they are checked for the temperature at the gate itself. At the same time, again, they have been sanitized, and they have to pass through a tunnel. When they have to get down from the trucks get disinfected, and then the same way they have to pass through the tunnel, again get down, pass through the tunnel, then again go into the truck, and then the bill goes for the unloading before getting unloaded and processed. So, you know, the entire change from the village level to the plant, there we need to be, you know, in order to prevent all the spread of this, any chance of spreading into the system. So all these things are very important, and at the same time, we are now continuously training every day. Every day, I will say, there is a small meeting before the truck driver leaves or the conductor leaves over to the village. They have been trained, they have been given every day new advisories, what action precautions that needs to be taken by them during this situation. So the point is, this is at the village level, cooperative society level. The next is, if you say at the factory level, what exactly needs to be done? The same thing which has been done. First thing is that, no, in any case, no case of corona inside the factory. That is what we want, and by God's grace, with all the efforts from everyone, there's not enough. You must have heard, whether it is a parlor at the marketing level, or whether it's a dairy at the plant level, or you have the village level, you will not find any case, because people have understood the importance of that, and that's why the social distancing part is also been taken at the village level, also at the plant level. Now, when it comes to plant, the most important aspect, you know, we all are ISO certified, but the time has changed, and now we need to put all these as a part of our system altogether, and for which we have now in Amul, we have made a manual out of it, and that manual is getting integrated with the ISO document. So this is all that is changing at this point of time. That's why we are ensuring hygiene and safety again to have the you know, the seamless operation. Now, trucks and all the milk has been brought by trucks, but what about the packing material? Now, the point here is that when the truck comes inside the premises with packing material, each and every, like, people have been quarantined, we are quarantining the packing material altogether, whatever it may be, whether it is machinery for projects, or whether it is civil work, or whether civil related items, or packaging material or raw material with the outer cover, everything has been quarantined, it has been unloaded at one point of time, and then you need to disinfect it, and then only keep it, and then need to shift it to the plant. So that is where, you know, the entire modus operandi of operation of the plant has changed to a large extent. The another most important aspect into this is the what we say is the unrestricted movement of the staff and the workers. That is where the, you know, people used to go to the canteens, and they used to go to the washrooms. Now, the entire dairy has now, when I talk of Amul, we say that the entire dairy has been put into three parts. We have our administration building, and the veterinary, and the society building, which we have been, we say that these people cannot go inside the plant at any point of time, not even for canteen facilities. So we have converted our food bank to a canteen facilities. Then we go to Amul 3 plant, it's a separate entity. So we are isolating the plants altogether. The moment of these people have been isolated, movement of the people for food, for canteen, for toilets, or any other thing are being segregated. The packing materials are at the one-time quarantine, but have been segregated by only designated people inside the premises. The identity cards and the passes are the most important. We know where exactly the person is working at. So more and more things are getting changed at the plant level. So when you see at the village level, you find a lot of changes. You will, when you reach into the premises of the dairy where the sanitizing, even you say sanitizers, sanitizer means now we started manufacturing sanitizer of WHO approved sanitizers. Then when you are saying that the roads also needs to the next step in the plant area premises, you know, what is that is the main point is the main gate. If you have a very stringent control across first shift, second shift, third shift, and you control the entry of the people with proper temperature monitoring, with proper hygiene, with disinfectant, the chances become very less. And then comes the trucks, you know, then coming. So what we done is now the entire premises has been sanitized with the pumps and, you know, it has been more digitized and more mechanized rather than the people person moving all together and disinfecting the different areas. Coming to the plants, we have almost now almost more than 20 advisories been released based on the advice from the central government, from the state government, or from the district registrar, or from the collector's office. You all those needs to be upgraded and updated with the communication being done to different level to avoid all these kind of you know any kind of problem in the plant. When it comes to operation of the plant, we say that the plant, we realize, to be very honest, that we can run the plant with less people, and most of the people hearing would also realize that in the plant itself, when we have less people coming inside the plant, but the operation was going on. That means less people can still operate the plant. So now at the plant level, you have the identification mark where you need to have the person standing who would be responsible to stand there and do his or her job over there. Now, when it goes further into processing part, particularly the most vulnerable thing is the crates which goes to the market, you know. That's where we need to take more care. So when the crate comes in, we are disinfecting the entire crate. Every crate has been disinfected at the first time before it enters inside the premises. The second is at the time of cleaning of the crates, you know, everybody needs to ensure that because it's been touched by every person. We have found many of our distributors also getting COVID positive, who were distributing the milk. But then we ensure that the crates which comes in are being sanitized through a sanitizing tunnel. So the next step was to have the sanitizing tunnel for not for the people, apart from the people. And every department has got its own tunnel. Every department has got its own sanitizer. Every department has got its own caps. The masks are given at the main gate itself. So from the entire chain, the temperatures are monitored at the main gate. So all these things are happening at this point of time. And the most important thing in the entire chain is that to ensure the sanitizing of the crate, apart from the crate getting, you know, we need to bring the temperature to more than 85 degrees centigrade to heat that crate and clean the crate to ensure that there are no chances the person who is taking out the crates from the vehicle needs to be very, very, you know, is it protected with PPE suits and with the gloves and mask and been taken care of. So all these things needs to be taken care at the, these are the most important thing. And with one more thing, see, one is that technically we people are working, but at the same time, we also need to ensure that there are advisories from the government on Ayush Mantralaya that we started giving, you know, Ukhaada we call it with the water, the herbs, and that is to be given. So each and every employee has been given Ukhaada at the plant level or at the office level. And also the homeopathy medicine, which government recommends, has been given to all the people across, whether it is whether it is the veterinary doctors or whether supervisors or at the plant level or the workers who are coming inside the plant. Now, here, there's a very important thing which we need to understand. The people who are working inside the plant may have a normal mask that can take care of it. But the people who are in the field, like doctors who are working or the supervisor, field supervisor, who are, they have been given N95 masks to ensure their safety because they have been in touch with the people at a very, very close proximity. So there we have been continuously giving more support to at the field level also. All the veterinary services are on 24/7, I think 1700 or 1800 visits been getting taken care of, almost 200,000, more than 2000 tons of cattle feed reaching to the farmers. So all these things, and when I talk of this is across Amul, like in Anand, Mogar, Gandhi, Vadra, Bombay, Pune, Kolkata, everywhere. And you can see these are some of the photographs, just to say, this is one kind of a PPE suit at the bottom. You can see the person going in the truck. He may be this fellow must be going to a COVID hit area. So we take care of that. Social distancing is already been, you can see a lot of social distancing, whether it is in canteen, whether the packing material needs to be getting sanitized. We have given, even apart from masks, where you have a manual line, there you have provided, we have provided the shields to the people that so that they can protect themselves in the plant, and we are also being protected. And you can see a lot of photographs where we are ensuring that all these things have been ensured and it has been implemented at all the levels. And we have got COVID-19 team, as Vineshbhai was talking about, that the advisory is like every 7 days all the people needs to be checked. So that is also now we are working. Self-declaration form has to be given by the employer, that has been digitized now. Even we are now ensuring with the software that which person is coming from where and how. How is very important. We realize that during peak time there were people who are coming in trucks which were carrying vegetables. So we have cases of vegetable positive cases. So we were constantly taking care of those people who were entering through those trucks inside the premises, and whether they are coming their own vehicle. And you can see that even the vehicles which they bring are being sanitized at the plant level. So everything which has been coming, these are the, you know, these are all the changes which we need to do. Apart from this, now what next? What should be the way forward? This is what our people have been talking about. And what we feel at Amul is digital communication, as Vineshbhai was also talking about the documentation in Amul. Almost for last, before the COVID started, we were the first people to have a paperless office. At this point of time, the entire communication is without any kind of you know, the paper movement. So that has helped a lot, and there are some papers which are still coming. We are working on that. Maybe next 4 or 5 months, you will not find any paper. Paper which comes at one point is getting, you know, it getting filed and scanned and filed, and then it moves digitally inside the system. So all these meetings, like the webinars, are happening more and more. Our team, the way of training has changed. In Amul now, almost every day we have got 4 or 5 webinars going on, and people are attending those webinars to see that the because you cannot go to the travel to for the training program. So that has already been started, and you can see even now we are working on a model which is a very, very unique model, is the digital social distancing. Now what is this? You know, everybody talks with digital the social distancing. Now we are working on our iCards. We are trying to put up a chip, and then we say that as the two people come in the proximity of each other in the control room, we come to know, and we continuously go on try to give the message on which the model which we are Amul is working, so that at least in the plant level people realize this, and same thing they can go back and implement at their home too. And thermal scanning, temperature is now being put up in Amul Dairy, and whenever you come, even if you have not wore the mask inside before entering the office, it will take out the mask. You don't have the mask, wear the mask, then your temperature has been taken care of, shot is taken, then you are inside, allowed to enter inside the building. So more of digital into the third point is the digital contactless system, like as told, thermal screening, auto sanitizer, auto controls, light controls, or you know, we were talking about Alexa, we're talking, and it was, you know, for us to do that. But this needs to be now more of a plant side that has to come in. More important is that digital process control, which is going to be the future, and we have also started, Amul has also started working. It's a screen mirroring you've been doing with your mobile on the TV, but now here we are saying that the entire HMI or the controls of the process are on your mobile. So you are using your mobile, which you are not touching the screen, more people are not touching the screen. That is what is going to be future, and we are still, Amul is working on that. Now, local distribution, home delivery, the software are on. We were a bit late, but at least now, very soon in Anand, very soon you will find that the home delivery system could take place, so people have to come out and ask for the things. So that is going to be the future. And as what we realize in this pandemic is the symptoms are very different. So we have been giving training to the people on yoga, immunity building, awareness programs, not even for employees but also for the family. Because if you are not the carrier, but you feel that you are you have COVID and you go back to home, and where your immunity of your family is not good, they may contact that. So your immunity should be at par with your home, your family member immunity. That is very important. That is going to be the emphasis point, because any employee having this kind of problem will lead to, you know, lot of complications with their family as well as for the plant member. So this is where we need to work. And this is the time to, you know, as we say that you need to think differently, and that's why we said recently I launched a healthy dude in the market, and we're going to have this the tulsi and the ginger milk coming in at the same time. You have Ayurvedic products like cookies and ginger cookies and high protein cookies will also be there in the market. So where you can improve the immunity of the people, that is going to be the key, because health is going to be more important than process comes second part, but the health will take care of that. And apart from that, you need to automate, you know, the expenses of, because your expenses are going up. So at the same time, optimizing the COVID expenses is going to be the few, like auto vehicles for disinfectant and development of sanitizer. Now we have a hypochlorite generators getting manufactured. We got the equipment, and we can now supply to the village level societies where we can bring down the cost. So what we are in all totality is talking about the Atmanirbhar program of Atmanirbhar, our Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister said that. So Amil is part of it, and that's what we would say that as the latest one is the stimulus package, local B and global B. So are we. So please take care of it. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your very clear and clear presentations and touching upon so many aspects of COVID-19, which I believe will be very useful to our viewers. Let us now take questions. And going along with your last slide, where you have shown certain new milks being launched, there is a question also that has come from one of the viewers, and that is there going to be a change in the way dairies manufacture new products? So the question being asked is, what kind of product will be useful for dairy food manufacturers for post-COVID-19?
The most important aspect is that right now, in this entire pandemic, what is the key which is there? It is only about the health. It's not about the health, but it's also about the immunity. How do you improve your immunity? And Amul, as milk, being as Prajapati have also stated, we have been there. It's one of the best product which is available at this on this earth, we would say this. So, only thing is, all other like Ayurvedic products which we have been talking about, we have been consuming, and India being on the top of it. That is why we are saying that more of haldi milk or turmeric milk or honey based milk or cinnamon, which is these are all been it been in written in the books, and many research have been done. So it is high time that we try to have these products available in the market, as well as it also has the taste. You know, people need to have the taste also. So it's a combination of that is going to happen. Certainly, it is, you know, such kind of situation, otherwise this would have come earlier also, but would have not clicked. But now it is time that we learn out of it and we continue to develop a new product, even for cheese, or you talk of any more other product, you find a lot of, which will be improving the immunity of the person. That is what the main focus.
In the same line, there's also a question in general, and which I think Dr. Jimmy Pilabhati would like to answer. How are dairy products useful in building immunity?
As Amit Bhai rightly told, milk, we know it is a nearly complete food. It has sufficient, you know, vitamins and minerals and good quality protein. Especially, we are talking something about the colostrum, rich in lactoferrins and immunoglobulin. So such components are already there. Apart from that, if you increase it, immune power by fermenting it with good lactic acid, as well as probiotics, and consume these, because we all know that more than 50% of the immunity of human being comes from the gut, that's the intestinal tract, and all this food goes inside the intestine, and there are millions of bacteria are there, and these bacteria decide whether it will be healthy or unhealthy. And if you try to enrich this bacteria, support this bacteria, providing them good bacteria, especially lactic acid bacteria, jo dahi mein hota hai, chhas mein hota hai, then you have more chances of strengthening your defense power. And that also fights against the common pathogen. Hamare purvaj kehte the, agar aapko diarrhea ho gaya, to kehte the beta chhas aur roti khalo. That means the bacteria which you consume through chhas has ability to fight against those which is causing bacteria. So, iske saath उसका भी रेजिस्टेंस बढ़ता है, एंड दैट इज व्हाई आई सजेस्ट दैट ऑल दोस प्रोबायोटिक कैटेगरीज ऑफ फूड व्हिच हैव बीन रिलीज्ड बाय डिफरेंट डेयरी प्लांट्स, एंड इन जनरल दी नॉर्मल दही एंड बटर मिल्क एंड लस्सी, दे आर एडवाइस टू स्ट्रेंथन योर इम्यूनिटी एंड टेक दिस अलोंग विद सम अदर प्लांट्स, वेजिटेबल, फ्रूट्स, फर्दर एनहांस इट न्यूट्रिशन वैल्यू एंड ऑल्सो एनरिच इट इन फाइबर. So that milk में जो deficiency है, fiber कम है, vitamin C कम है, iron कम है, तो ऐसे इसे blend करके खाओ तो आपका immunity strong रहता है.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to the questions, we got different types of questions. So I think the next one would be meant for executive director Dinesh Sir. What is the support from the government to address COVID-19 related stress on dairy sector?
I think I did touch in my opening remark that the major support which Government of India has extended to the dairies is the interest subvention scheme. In the last week, this scheme is announced. It is for the year 2020-21. So, from 1st April to 31st March 2021, all the milk which is converted to commodities, long shelf life commodities like SMP, WMP, butter and ghee. And against this stock, if you are taking a working capital loan from any bank, including regional banks or cooperative banks or the public sector banks or any financial institution, against these stocks, it is a secured loan. The government of India through NDDB will provide 2% interest subvention every month to the banks directly for the cooperatives who have obtained the capital loan. In addition, if the cooperatives are regular in making the payment to the banks from where they have taken the loan, at the end of the at the end of 1 year when the loan is complete, a 2% additional interest subvention will also be provided. So this is the scheme which has already been announced, and I think the cooperatives can take them.
Thank you, sir. I think that is very useful to our many people who are doing. This is a very positive information. Next question is a bit technical and tactical, again to Sridhar. Is there a negative impact on of use of sanitizers on milk tankers and employees in the dairy plant, and maybe the negative use of fruits and vegetables which are asked? And what is the strength required for getting an effective sanitation?
When we talk of sanitization, the first thing is that when you are sanitizing the disinfecting the vehicles, you know, that's you are not disinfecting the tanker inside the tank. Inside the tanker is again the CIP which is going on at this point of time. So that is not going to hamper anything. You have your own CIP system wherein you can have caustic acid or hot water and sterilize it and use the tanker. It is only about the outer periphery on the vehicle. So, and the when I said about the packing material also, it is also about the outer periphery which has been covered. So we are not touching the inside of the material. So all these things are outside. Now coming to human, there has been n number of school of thoughts which has been going on. A lot of debates have been going on this use hypochloride or not. We have shifted to chlorine based system for particularly the people who are passing through the tunnel. Hypochloride also, we realized that less than 58 ppm is not a problem. And till date, to be very honest, people have been talking this will happen, that will happen. We have been using this tunnel for last almost 2 months now, because we made this tunnel as soon as we came in the we came to know that this will be required. So we made it in 1 day. We made 4 tunnels in departmentally only. And from that day, at that time, we were using hypochlorite. But we did not had any kind of problem to any of the people or any irritation on the skin. Or people are talking that they may have. If the concentration is not proper, then in that case, it may happen. But at least for Amul, till date, we have not found any.
Thank you, sir. I think that allays so many fears associated with the sanitation process, which is being recommended. There's a question also which probably has been answered, but I think it is being asked again and again. Does coronavirus spread through milk and milk products?
The clear cut answer is no. Especially these milk and milk products, as far as the milk is handled by the organized sector, it is processed, it is pasteurized thoroughly. And apart from the undesirable bacteria, viruses are also killed. However, especially unorganized sector who is selling milk in use, I advise the consumer that it must be boiled before it is consumed so that you don't have any chance of this. But all the milk and milk products, including ice cream, because some people had some apprehension that ice cream may cause corona, it is not the case. These milk products are thoroughly processed. Uske andar itne sare processes hote hain ki usme koi virus zinda rehne ka koi chances nahi. Only thing, we should be careful about the outer packet of that. If we feel that it is put in crates, it is not clean, or it is outside of the polythene or other things, or maybe a certain percent, thoroughly wash it so that you have no chances of getting contaminant inside the product. So be safe, and thank God that viruses are very host specific. They are the one virus which infects one kind of animals or plants, do not do any harm to others. And that is why we have no risk of getting it transferred from one species to another species. And this virus especially is having a liquid layer on the top and easily getting disintegrated by simple soap, what is it, soap also. So be vigilant and can't be worried about consumption of essential products. We are totally safe.
Thank you, sir. And I think you already answered one of the questions, but I think just to be just to the person who asked this question, does coronavirus spread from humans to animals? I would like to ask Dinesh Sagar.
No, again, the answer is clear cut no. I think we have all the research available to suggest that there is no evidence which says that this virus can get transmitted from the human to animal. As I think Dr. Prajapati also told in his remark, that, you know, these are the mutated virus, and this mutation has helped this COVID-19 to, you know, impact the human. But it does not mean that it will go from human to animal. So all the evidence is so far suggests that there is no chance of transmission from human to animal.
Thank you, sir. That is nice for our farmers. And I would like to ask one question to Amit Vyas, sir. People are asking how to minimize operational costs of dairy plants. Capacity utilization in some dairies has gone down to almost 50% during lockdown. While we are also witnessing, you know, some dairies procuring more than their capacity, there is also a case that some dairies are handling less. So they are worried as to how to minimize the costs.
To be very honest, when this situation was there, under those circumstances, the priority, you know, again, it depends on the priority. What exactly is the priority? That time when the milk was coming more and people were less, we changed the entire our SQ program. Like we said that, okay, that it's only time to have SMP and butter being made so that at least we dispose of them. The first thing. So that was a situation when the milk was more, people were less, and we were in the transit phase, what to do, what not to do. So first thing was handling of the milk itself. So once the milk got handled, then now slowly the market is moving up, it's getting more open. So you know, what we did was we closed down many of our operations at one point of time. We stopped ghee, we stopped the flavored milk. Those were the areas where we thought that you require more manpower, which is the product is not going to go. Ice cream was closed down at that point of time. All those people will utilize a different. So this is where, again, it depends on from the organization to organization. What is the demand of the market at this point in that particular area? So for us, it was initial days was to convert into powder and butter. But now, when your capacity comes down 50%, it is always better to run the plant at 100%. If you see worldwide, you know, Saturday and Sundays are off. So what they do with the milk? People talk a lot about that in India, you can't keep milk for more than so much time. But if you chill the milk, keep it and try to utilize maximum. By ensuring your power, fuel, water, labor, your machine maintenance, you know, you should utilize this time for maintaining the machine. At the same time, utilize your time to have a good product mix that is required by the market at this point. So, utilizing your plant capacities, and as you must have seen that we also innovated some products at this point of based on the need that has to be done. So, depending on the market, we said that okay, smaller packs are more in demand because people the hotel, restaurant, and our HoReCa segment was totally down. So we said that okay, let us make it for the consumer. So more consumer pack. So you need to continuously identify where exactly the product would be going. So in that case, our DCMF has done great job. Sodi MD has taken the right decisions, and based on that, today now in the second month of this COVID, we are now moving plus on the sales side. So it was initially, yes, 1 month was a tough time, but now we have come out of it and we are on the moving track. In fact, we are going plus compared to last year.
Thank you, sir. I think we have a few minutes. I can take one last question for Minister, sir. There are certain concerns being raised by people about the price being paid to the farmer getting reduced in current times. And also some participants want to know, can we predict trends of S&P and butter prices in future post COVID-19? So would you like to?
I think based on my experience, I can only say that this is a purely temporary phenomenon. Yes, I understand that there is a problem. Cooperatives are handling much more milk than what they are supposed to in the rainy season. like last year, this time, if you compare this time, the cooperatives are handling maybe 10 to 15% more milk against a normal drop of 10%. So they are handling much more milk. There are problems associated because at the same time, the demand of the milk is low. So this is a temporary thing. As Amit also told, we are slowly opening. The lockdown is now only confined to the containment zones and most of the country is open. I hope that with the increase in demand, more and more milk they will be able to sell. And with the revenues coming in and with the product mix, I think going back to normal, their margins will improve. And again, the money being paid to farmers will increase. I do hope that considering the lean season ahead, the prices of commodities will come up. Farmers will get higher price. However, for them to happen, they'll have to wait for some time to get this temporary phenomenon go. Things become normal and to get food price.
Thank you, sir, for your presentations and very clear answers to the queries. With this, I think we would like to close this webinar. I would like to thank all the participants.